stays up. Brewers had his best game by far in this series. Here's Philpott, almost lost his footing in front. Here they come again. Open net. Callahan scores! No goal! No goal!
Let's see.
There's a huddle.
Interference with the goaltender. Okay, but where was the goaltender? To me, Kleiss had a hard time getting back to his net because he was way out of it. Watch PK Subban here come back to the net. A bouncing puck knocks it out as it might have come in. Where's the interference? There is none. Not a chance. That should be a goal.
It's no contact by number 17 for Tampa Bay. No goal.
That's a terrible call. In the process of making the play, he gets back in. Price jumps into him, and that's why the puck ends up in the back of the net. Personally, I don't agree with that.
It's so far after the contact. That's maybe that last one is where they're calling it.
Again, he's getting out of the crease, and Price does a smart thing, though. He goes at him, and he engages him. Glenn, you've had this a million times in your career.
And to me, Price kind of sells it there.
Totally. Price goes and bumps into him. What a break for Montreal.
It is a rookie playoff referee, Francis Chiron, in his second ever playoff game that made the call.
Boy, what a big break. And he's going no call there. Still didn't make a response. That is way too late. He allowed that play to happen. Didn't wave it off. Called safe on the first contact. And then called it after the fact that the puck was in the net, and John Cooper is going nuts.